What's up, internet friends? Tiff Getty here, pro photographer and helicopter pilot. Here to discuss with you the results of selling my gear to MPB. Now, before I get started, I do want to heavily caveat this, that I'm usually much more of a stickler on timing. It's tough to part with gear that you love and are using only to have, you know, money from it 2 months after you mailed it in. I would definitely be a critic in that regard, but considering today's climate and what we're dealing with, I am going to cut them a huge break, and I probably will discuss generally just dates and timelines, but by no means am I holding them to anticipated or forecasted dates and timelines, because I'm giving them the benefit of the doubt, as we should. If we were not in the midst of a global pandemic, I'm assuming they would be much more timely and have more personnel and the ability and available bandwidth to get on it a lot faster. So with that in mind, let's get to it. So just to quickly recap, I submitted two separate orders or shipments to MPB. I think I sent them on March 9th. And right now I have been paid for both of them. And again, like I said, I'm not going to get hung up on timelines at this point, because that wouldn't be fair and that wouldn't make sense. So they made adjustments to both of my submissions, but in a very reasonable manner, and for stuff that I would expect. So the first one was an adapter, my Nikon to Sony E-mount adapter. The only one that they had pre-populated when I tried to put mine in there was the Metabones one, which mine was not. It was a third-party one. So they did not pay me for that, but they sent me just a quick synopsis and said, we'd be happy to return the item free of charge to your address on file. And then they adjusted the quote accordingly and sent me the new quote for that one. So that one ended up being my A6000 Sony. And then the one kit lens, which was the, I think it was the 16-50mm, and then an additional lens I'd purchased, which was the 55-210. And for all of those, they accepted my condition. I had listed one lens in good and the other two in excellent. They agreed with all that and paid me out $320, which, boom, fair. And let's see. The second order I had was my Nikon and my drone. So the changes they made to that were the two kit lenses that came with it. They said there was too much sand in them. They were a bit seized up, which I had caveated that when I sent them in. I let them know they were not in stellar condition and tried to be upfront with that, but they said there's nothing they could do with those at this point. So again, they sent me a follow-up email saying, you know, we're happy to send them back to you free of charge, which I'll probably have them do. I don't know. I'll make a video and we can dissect them together and see what goes into a lens. Something like that, because I took them out to Colorado to the Great Sand Dunes National Park and was in like the middle of a windstorm and was obviously ill-prepared to protect my gear. Those kit lenses are plastic. They're not weather sealed. So although everything else survived, those two seem to be casualties and a learning experience for properly protecting your gear. So after they took those two off, everything else, my Sigma lens, my 150-600mm, I said was in excellent condition. They agreed. Oh, then I had my DJI Spark, sayonara, and the Flymore combo, and then two additional batteries, which kind of sucks, but the Spark batteries aren't that expensive, so even in excellent condition, I got $8 for each of those batteries. The Flymore combo, I got $265. Everything was in excellent condition. My Nikon DSLR, the D5500, I received $235 for it. They said that was in excellent condition. And for my Sigma lens, they gave me $470, which is actually pretty darn good because I've had that lens for, I don't know, 3-4 years now. I did baby it, but I've still had it for a long time. So in total for that second order, they paid me $986. And only rejected 3 things, which, I mean, in today's day and age, resale is such a big thing. I mean, I know I either donate or resell all of my clothes, and a lot more of those get rejected. And when it comes to something like this for my profession, and that can be ruined a lot easier, I think that this is pretty darn fair, and I'm super stoked on it. So yeah, $986 for this one and $320 for the other one, and they just wired it directly into my bank account, no problems. So overall, it was a really good experience. I will use them again for sure, and I would recommend them. When I use them in the future, I'll obviously pay a little more attention to timelines and this and that, but right now when, you know, Amazon is taking 3 weeks to deliver something, I'm not going to be on anybody else's case as far as timeliness goes. I know staffing is bare bones and everything else, or people are working from home. So all in all things considered, I'm stoked. I'm really happy with the interaction. It was easy to pack up and ship. FedEx came right to my house. They sent me free shipping labels, and I haven't received my gear back from them that they rejected, but I'm assuming that I will, giving them the benefit of the doubt there too. It was a good experience. So in my personal opinion, not sponsored or anything, I would definitely recommend doing business with them in the future. They've taken good care of me and good care of my gear. So thanks, MPB. And thanks for watching, guys. I hope this video helped you and was informative. And if so, please hit that like button. And if you haven't already, please smash that subscribe button. I will see you guys soon. Take care. Be safe. See ya.